And let's synthesize some bitter potions. I should check the Kaiser potions too. I'll get 15 of these. But Kaiser potions, they require rota leaves. I don't think so. Not for right now. Anyways, the next destination is right here on the map. So I guess I've got to go to the Ruse Nest and then start running that way. It'll take a second to get back to that path though. Okay, here we are. You know what? I kind of want to switch in a different character. Let's switch in him. And now I'll switch over to him and equip him with the Warrior Seal 4. I'll give her the Warrior Seal 3 and a, let's see, Power Ring 4. Yeah, it seems like a good idea. So now he can equip the other two. Just like so. And check out his skills very fast. All of them are level 1 and 2. So. Oh, wow. I like the fact that he immediately learned a new skill as soon as I did that. I'll probably be trying that skill out in there. Near future here. Gaia Spear was learned. Catholicon. So, let's take another quick look at the map. To the right is where I need to go for the flag as well as the memory. Whoops, I did not mean to do that. Okay, we're going to be returning to this spot here in a bit, I'm sure. That area is definitely looks like a shortcut needs to be made there or something. Actually, if I look at the map, it doesn't indicate that there's supposed to be a shortcut there. What the? What just happened? I think that they found a resource or something. I thought it seemed awfully cold. Is this snow? Indeed, this is the sacred Mount Vesuvio. It's said that before taking up the throne, King Lafonce isolated himself here to prepare himself for the challenges ahead. I have never seen nor heard tell of such peculiarly shaped mountains before. Blah. Which of the peaks should we be aiming for? There seems to be two of them. Two very distinct ones, yes. The eastern peak is always covered in snow, while the western peak is an active volcano, always billowing smoke like it is now. We can't climb the western peak at the moment, but we should be able to reach the snowy eastern peak from here. The Grand Rue and the Rota Tree felt an energy here similar to the Mask of the Moon, so we don't have much choice. I suggest we not think too much about the road ahead and just start climbing. Come along now, pick up the pace. This is, what's his name? Leo. Right? Yep. Left, right, left! Holtman! 1, 2, 3! At ease. I'm exhausted, Sancho. Why do we have to keep running around like this? And why is it so cold here? If you want to stay warm, keep moving. Being cold is your body's way of telling you that it's not moving fast enough. Please let us rest! If it isn't at all, have you come to get in our way again? You know, I can totally see you getting in our way, but I can't remember a single instance where we've gotten in yours. What are you doing here, anyway? Aren't you supposed to be tailing Gruta? Because trust me, you're way off the mark if you think he's near this mountain. Ha! We're not telling. It's our secret, and we'll take it to the grave with us if we have to. Wow. Right, Commander? No. I'll tell you if you really want to know. What? That's not like you. They helped us out in the Ashen Forest, and I despise being indebted to people. But we worked so hard to get that information. Silence! Stinginess is not befitting of a Roman soldier. And now listen, and listen well. There's currently a large group of Nast Division soldiers mobilized on this mountain. Really? And yet Gruta is inside the Temple of the Sun. There are places with their commanding officers, so I couldn't help but wonder why they'd come here instead. My instincts tell me they're looking for something important on this mountain. Huh, that's not good. Could they be looking for the Mask of the Moon as well? That seems the most likely possibility. Eldil should certainly know of its existence. I guess we need to pick up the pace then. Still, I'm surprised you three managed to uncover that kind of intelligence. That's a pretty good work. Well, when you spend most of your days running around, you do overhear a lot of things. Yep, all you're doing is hiding and listening after all. Silence! Before we go on ahead, I have one final question. Young lady, would you happen to be related to a man named Remnos? You know Remnos? Much as I don't trust him, he is still technically a fellow Roman commander, and he seems quite capable in his role. So you... That is to say, if you want another chance to talk to him, you should go on ahead. And you should hurry. What? Right. That's enough rest, men. Sancho, Panza, we're leaving.
What?
But we only got here.
Oh, boy.
Or just got here. Give it up, Panza. You know he's not going to listen.
No.
Onward, march. Wait. Commander, wait for us. Off they go. Hey, let's get that resource very fast because it's been on my mind. I didn't even see that before. Oh, I've got to switch to Adol. Even though Adol is in my team, they can't just automatically allow me to use it without switching to him. Huh. Excuse me, Governor General. Governor General? Oh, it's you, Leo. My apologies, I was lost in thought. I admit I am somewhat surprised upon hearing that you, of all people, became the Governor General of Celceta. I'd never expected to find the fourth princess of the Imperial Roman Empire herself in a place like this. Wow. Please don't call me that. Here, I'm to be regarded solely as Governor General Griselda. Besides, I've been scorned by the Empire in as much the same way you have. Roaring Leo. I see. But I have no intention of looking back upon my past with shame. I firmly believe there must be a task that only we can complete here in this land. Whatever that task may be, I'll be counting on you, Commander Leo. Yes, ma'am. I am honored. There's more than meets the eye to both of them. I don't remember if we ever learned about Griselda being a princess before. Did I actually activate that? Yeah, I did. Okay, I wasn't sure. Oopsie. I meant to have him. Whoops. These guys aren't weak to anything, but that means they're also not strong to anything. Which is always preferred. What's this? Okay. Darn it. Okay. Sometimes it's really hard to control his abilities. Which is a shame because, you know, I want to use them to level them up, but when you're not hitting stuff half the time with them, I mean, kinda makes you feel like there's no point. Huh, oopsie. Nope. At all learned Gale Stinger. Cool. Power Tablets has been obtained. And we'll eventually get up there, somehow. This area is kind of reminding me just a little bit of that one place in East 2. There's that one mountain that we had to climb up. Although the enemies here are far more manageable. Because in that place, you could die really easily. Let's see. Ooh. As long as they're stunned initially, then it's not too hard to hit them with this ability. And then he goes and misses them anyway, darn it. Die! Water Prison is definitely his best ability for the moment. Which way should I go? Oh, okay, that makes sense. I was like, I was looking at the map and thinking, you know, there doesn't seem to be a clear path forward, but there was. I'm glad I came up here first. I almost went the path that you have to take eventually, you know, this path right up here. Whoops. Come on. Oh, I should, what's it called? Equip the urn. And there is a memory nearby. Oh. Not gonna let me fight first? I guess they don't want us to skip this particular memory. These two again. I'm impressed that you knew where to find me. Should you really be here now? Your five retainers are worried about your absence from the temple. As the place where I first swore to become king, this is the starting point of who I am now. There's nowhere more suitable when I wish to think undisturbed. You can be quite the troublesome monarch, disappearing every time you have something to think about. Ha! So, I heard about the tower. What inspired you to build one in such a place? Oh, nothing in particular. It's just a little retreat for myself. Perhaps a place suitable for me to think undisturbed. Are you intending to leave El Duke then? One day, yes. I told you before, I intend to leave the kingdom of Celceta to mankind. Once I feel mankind is ready to take care of her. But it is best to do so in stages. First, I shall leave the Temple of the Sun, and lend support from behind the scenes. Yes, I recall you discussing that plan once before. I intend to gradually move more and more into the background. So much so that one day, people will completely forget my existence. At which point, I'll merely watch over them. Living a life of peace and serenity. Well, that's my plan anyway. I see. I would expect no less from you. Well, wish me luck, old friend. I'm going off to work towards this retirement of mine bit by bit. Adel's maximum HP increased by 10. Another of King LaFonce's memories. Seems to have taken place right here, too. Which means there could still be others in the area. I suspect you're right. We should keep an eye out for more as we go. So, when will we get down to where those two treasure chests are? Also, the enemies that were right there despawned, which I'm not really a fan of. Let's go back out here and fight them very fast. I wanted to make sure I didn't miss any unique enemies, just in case. You never know. What the? They kind of look like the cross between a penguin and a dragon. They at least act a little bit like a penguin would, I think. Sliding on their bellies, I don't know. Okay. Thankfully, I didn't have to use the shoes to dash up the slope. They haven't actually had us do that ever since we got the shoes. It's very slippery in here. Like, the characters slide around a little bit when you, are running. Oh, they went underground. I thought they went up high. Cool. Is that all right there? Yep. Starlight stones. I think that's the first time I've ever seen them. Could be wrong. Cool. Always nice to see characters leveling up. Whoops. Why'd you aim that way, dude? That was weird. Shield tablet. And there we go. I just remembered, I should have, what do you call it? Oh! He can kind of fly up. Wasn't expecting that. Anyways, I should have gone and upgraded one of my, what do you call it? Artifacts? Oh, I just realized what you're supposed to do. I should have done the one on the right first. And it's not a big deal. Oh, you can... Okay, it is a little bit of a big deal. I would have had to have done it that way regardless, but... for right now, let's get rid of these enemies. Wasn't there another enemy over here? No? Never mind then. But the next time I get a, what do you call it? A teleporter, I'll go back to Danon and do that. Hopefully they let me switch back over to, what's his name? Before the next fight starts. Although I'll have to switch her back in anyways, just to get back up to where that was, but... Okay. Gimme. Courage belt. Very nice. Will the enemies that are up there come down? No? Oh yeah. I think that the one that jumped down already teleported back up there. The fact that they make you do that twice is a little bit annoying. Yeah, having to steal the fissure, you know, repeatedly over and over again like that. If I'd done it correctly the first time, I wouldn't have had to have done it nearly as many times, but... It still felt like an awful lot. Okay, which way should I go? To left or straight up ahead? Well, to left I see a treasure chest, though. Oh wow, it got kind of knocked on the ground. No thank you. I still got hit. Okay, cool. No! Okay, good. I was worried that it would go all the way into the ground. A diamond. Have I ever gotten those before? I'm starting to get a little bit worried about this path. It does. Okay, it does end. I was about to say, it doesn't seem to be ending. But, it definitely does. And my character's got frozen. Do I have anything to cure that? Well, I do have the Catholicons, but I don't really want to use those if I can avoid it. Guess I have to, though, in this case. I should look into seeing whether or not I can buy those from the store. And now I'm not going to underestimate these guys because of that status. No treasure chest. This really long hallway for no treasure chest. That's bizarre. There we go. Anything else in this crazy room? No? Geesh. Let's get... Oh my goodness! I was not expecting this! Wow. I don't even think I can actually attack right now. Oh wow. Guard elixir. What happens if I drop off? I don't really want to drop off right there. I'm actually a little bit worried about that. What's in here? Oh, the treasure chest that I've been looking for. Oh, great. I have to cure them again. You know what? I've got a better idea. What if I equip... Where is it? Wait, does somebody else have it equipped? She has it, yeah. Let's give her something else, like the power ring, too. Temporarily equip that, charm that prevents freezing. No, it doesn't work that way. Never mind. I had to try it. You never know, some games that would actually work. But in this particular case, it does not. Darn it, I was frozen again. How long does it take before you get unfrozen? Okay, it doesn't take that long. So I shouldn't use that unless, you know, the Catholicons, unless it's an emergency. Being stuck between those two enemies was, in fact, an emergency. I got a rune cloak plus 7. Let me see. 46 defense increased for him. Same for him. She's already got a rune cloak. Why does she have a rune cloak? She have a rune cloak, but the rest of them don't. Oh, that's because you're able to buy those from the Rune Village, right? Let's go ahead and equip that on him, since I'm using him right now. And I may as well heal up and save. And that will be the end of this video, so thank you very much for watching, and if you enjoyed it, please leave a like, comment down below, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye!